Hello, Bearcat Nation. Are you pumped? Welcome, Coach Tommy. And welcome to our family, Bearcat Nation. Let's make some more noise. Coach Tommy, did you know that you have entered the hashtag hottest college in America? The University of Cincinnati is a great university, founded in 1819, and one of the top 25 research universities in America, with 20 top 20 programs. And a school that has produced a U.S. president, vice president, Supreme Court justices, and winners of the Nobel Prize, the Oscar, Tonys, and Emmys. This is an awesome school. We are one of only three universities in America that were in the top 25 in basketball, research, and football last year. And we are crazy about our sports teams. Most importantly, we have the best band in the world. The best cheerleaders in the world. The best student section in the world. And the best fans. There is no more intimidating stadium in the nation than Nippert, and we will make noise for you every game. Just yesterday I said we would find not only an excellent coach, but one who wants to be in Cincinnati and who commits to stay here and take us to the next level. Kudos to our awesome athletic director, Whit Babcock, for bringing you here. Bearcat Nation, I present to you one of the best living college football coaches in history, Coach Tommy. You guys, we expect greatness from you, but we'll be firmly behind you. Together, we will fly the UC flag and honor this great university. Welcome to our family. You are going to love it here, Bearcat Nation. And with that, let me introduce our athletic director, Whit Babcock.
Thank you. It's a great day to be a Bearcat. I'm proud to welcome Tommy, Suzanne, and one of their two sons, Troy, to the Bearcat family this evening. Suzanne is truly back home, and she is from Guilford, Indiana, near our higher ground training facility, so it's really great to welcome her truly back home. Every search process is different. I had no idea yesterday that I'd be standing before you today. I truly didn't. But I'm honored and humbled to be doing so tonight, and I'm very thankful. I'd like to also express my appreciation for our team here at UC that helped put all this together, led by Bob Arklepain and a lot of the rest of our staff that put all this together on short notice, and I'd really like to recognize them. Coach Tuberville and I worked together at Auburn from 1999 to 2002. And even then, I was really impressed, or what struck me then was his true leadership, his CEO-style leadership, how he molded young men on and off the field, his relentless recruiting, his family-centered values. He helped me as a first-time parent. Now, he didn't babysit for my kids or anything like that, but watching him as a parent of young boys when I was just getting started, he was a great role model for me in that way. He absolutely had a knack for winning the big games and still does. And I also remember how he treated every fan and every staff member, including me as a 29-year-old middle manager, for lack of a better term, and I'll never forget that. We've kept in touch over the years, most recently when I was at the University of Missouri and he was at Texas Tech. And I remember going down to Lubbock for a game, and I was just standing over on the side of the field pregame, and Coach Tuberville yells at me and waves me out on the field, and I realize I'm standing there 10 minutes before the game behind their offensive huddle, and we're talking like we're just sitting there on the golf course. And eventually he's like, "Whit, I got to go to work," and off he goes. We've had phone calls here and there over the years and months, and he's always been gracious. His style and personality will fit perfectly in this wonderful community where we are all proudly Cincinnati. As I mentioned on Friday, every athletic director should have a succession plan if a coach happens to leave. Coach Tub, as his players call him, was at the top of our list. Late yesterday, our search team, Dr. Ono, Bob Arklepain, Omar Banks, and I decided to swiftly try and secure our top candidate. This morning, we received the support of Fran Barrett, the chair of the Board of the Trustees, and the rest of our trustees to move forward. I am truly thankful for their trust and vision in our plan. This morning, I called Texas Tech Athletic Director Kirby Holcutt, and I left him a message on his cell phone that I'd like to talk to Coach Tuberville about our position. That it would be a one-day move with our best possible offer, and if it wasn't successful today, we would move on to our other candidates as quietly as possible. I left Kirby a second message and was unable to reach him, but I would like to say this, and I don't know, or I kind of know, but I can only imagine what he's going through down there. Kirby has been a role model of mine. He is a top-shelf guy, and I'm a bit embarrassed for having to leave him two messages and not reach him directly. Coach and I then spoke for approximately 20 minutes on the phone, and I laid out the parameters of our deal. In addition, I talked about his wife being able to come home and how he could build on the tremendous success and foundation that Coach D'Antonio, Coach Kelly, Coach Jones, and others had built. I told him we could move it forward together. I also noted that he would not have to change his red and black wardrobe. I knew if we were going to be successful in securing Coach Tuberville, we needed to move fast. I shared with him that we had a plane on standby donated by a generous donor if he was willing to pull the trigger. I was obviously thrilled with his interest, as he said he would discuss it with his family and then speak with his athletic director and team. His agreement with us will be for a five-year contract. Other details will be forthcoming once completed. Coach has also agreed to donate over the term of those 5 years $300,000 over the term to supplement our Olympic sport programs. His willingness to buy into our saying or our slogan that we're 547 student athletes, 143 staff, 18 sports, and one team. The fact that he bought into that right off the bat is tremendous, and I'm thankful. I'm thankful for his answer of yes today. It's a testament to all of UC. It's a testament to our board, our administration, our faculty, our staff, our students, our academic leaders, our alumni, our foundation, our UCATS donors, and our fan base, all of whom have built UC into what it is today and have played a key role in today's celebration. We'd like for Coach Tuberville to finish his career here, and I believe he's wanting to put down those roots. His bio and his 17-year track record of championship bowls, bowl wins, undefeated seasons, Coach of the Year honors, team academic awards, and his commitment to comprehensive excellence speaks for itself and are too numerous for me to read here. Coach Tuberville is the man for the job. He's now a Bearcat. Simply put, now is the time, this is the place. Please welcome your new coach, Coach Tommy Tuberville.
Thank you. Thank you. President Ono, Witt, board members, cheerleaders, band, students, alumni and fans. Bearcat Nation, Bearcat family, I'm proud to be a Bearcat! You can do a lot of things with emotion and energy, and we got it here. There's been a lot of success here over the years. I was walking down the hallways a few minutes ago and saw all the great coaches and all the great football players. The beautiful facilities here on campus that have been provided for the students here at University of Cincinnati. But everything that you see is just mostly physical. You know, emotion pays dividends. You know, feelings pay dividends. That's how you win. That's how you're successful. And I don't care if it's a football game or academics or family or life. And this is great to see. It really is. You know, it's been a long day for me, as I just told the football team here, sitting on each end. I met with them just a few minutes ago. I left a good group of young men about 1,500 miles away, and I was proud of every one of them. We went through some tough times and some great times. And that's what athletics is about. You know, I'm looking forward to the challenges here that our football team, our university, basketball, our athletic department have. We have a lot of challenges. I just happen to be a small part of it. I want to be a leader that helps this university go to the next level. Not that there hadn't been a lot of accomplishments. There has. There's been a lot of great wins, championships. A lot of great things happen. But there's always a next step. I'm going to get questions as, why did you come to Cincinnati? That's exactly it. I want to help the Bearcat Nation take that next step forward. Take the next step to what we can do to be better every day as a group and as a university. I have some family here today. I want to introduce my wife, Suzanne. Just raise your hand there, Suzanne. My son, Troy. My mother-in-law and daddy-in-law, right here. Like I said, it's been a long day for us, but this welcome has really made it worthwhile. You know, late night, you know, the enthusiasm of what this university has, I'm just glad to be a part of it. We're going to start today, and we're going to start inching forward every day. As I told this football team, they have a bowl game to play here in a few weeks, and I know they can do it. My job is to put together a staff that's second to none, and we'll do that. We'll bring guys in here that, number one, want to be here, want to work here, have the same values, have the same goals, and then we'll in turn begin and continue to recruit every day young men that want to be part of this university to get a great degree and play great football. So as we start this journey ahead, it's just not me, it's all of us together. We start tonight, we go to work tomorrow, and we work every day to make this university better in every possible way that we can, successful on and off the field, with great young men and women that are eventually going to go out and be great individuals and great Americans, because we live in the greatest country on the face of this earth. Got a few gentlemen up here on the front row that probably like to ask a few questions.
Tommy, welcome to Cincinnati.
Wait a minute, I've seen your picture before. What's that? I think I've seen you put your picture before.
You may have, I don't know. My question is, what was your initial reaction when Whip called? Were you shocked?
Well, it was such a quick turnaround. You know, in our business, you don't have time to really react or think for a while when situations like this happen. You know, this is not my first rodeo. Most of you can tell I'm not from the state of Ohio with my accent, but I'm learning. It has been very quick. I got my first phone call, I guess less than 10, 12 hours. That's how quick this can change. And I was perfectly satisfied, had a great home, Lubbock, Texas, and the people of West Texas are great people. They love football. Our football team played hard. Our staff did a great job of coaching. But there was something when Whit called that I thought, you know, let me think about this, because most of my name is, over the years, has been, for some reason, it just goes out like a light if there's a job open. Everybody thinks I ought to be the coach there. Not that I'm bragging, it's just we won a few games over the years, and it just goes out there, and it just kind of goes over my head. This job did not do that. It kind of caught my eye. I've had a chance to watch, over the years, Cincinnati play on television, playing very big games, bowl games, BCS games, watched the success. It just kind of, something kind of rang. I don't know what it was. And we just started dialogue, and one thing led to another. And, of course, it's a family decision. My wife and I and my two boys. And we thought about it and prayed about it, and here we are. And we have no doubt this is the best decision that could have been made.
Coach Tuberville, Whit Babcock said the other day that if he could get a head coach in place soon enough, that it was possible that that head coach might coach in the bowl game. Has that been discussed with you?
No. I think that the situation the way it is, so close to a game. I think these guys need the direction of the people that have been working with them. I think it gives them the best opportunity to be successful. I'll stay in the background. My duties for the next few days is to get acclimated to the university and to the people and everything around, begin hiring the staff, but recruiting. You know, regardless of what you think, players win games. And it's all about recruiting. And we've got players here that are committed to us, and I'll follow up on that. I'll make a lot of phone calls over the next few days, and we'll open more inroads. You know, we're going to spend a huge amount of time within a 200-mile radius of this campus. And I grew up under some very good coaches. I learned under Jimmy Johnson and Dennis Erickson, R.C. Slocum. They had a lot of success. And the one thing I learned from those guys was the closer you take your players to your campus, the better success, the better retention that you'll have. And so that's what we want to do. We'll go to California, and we'll go to Florida, and we'll go to Texas. But I want a majority of our players to come from this area because there's great football here and there's great people.
Coach Tuberville, have you talked to your staff at Texas Tech, and will any of them be following you here to Cincinnati?
Top one, I couldn't understand.
Texas Tech,
coaches? Yeah, we had a meeting today with the coaches, Texas Tech, and they'll all coach the bowl game there. They're playing in the Meineke Car Care Bowl in Houston against Minnesota day after the Bearcats play. And I thought it was only right for the staff there to stay, to give them that same opportunity to win. But there will be some come from that staff. There will be some come from other areas. Like I said, I'm a true believer of getting the best possible staff for the situation that we possibly can. I'm not sold on any offense, defense. Everybody says, what's your philosophy? My philosophy is to give the players the best chance to win. As I told the players earlier, I like to run the ball. I like to throw the ball. And we were the number one passing team in the country this year at Texas Tech. Number one. But I think it all goes back to one thing. You have to be consistent in what you do. What we will do is we'll bring a coaching staff that believes in what they want to do, all of us together, and we'll teach that to these players coming in, and we won't change. I mean, we want to teach them how to play football, give them the best opportunity to win on every play, whether it's offense or defense. We're going to be very consistent. We'll have a great weight program, and we're going to try to produce as much speed as we possibly can. So everybody talks about philosophies of the football coach. It has to change. It has to change with the times, and it has. I've seen more change in college football in the last 6 or 7 years than I saw in my first 25, and you have to change with it. But again, it all goes back to the players that you have and what they can do and what they can't do, giving them the best opportunity and chance to win.
Coach, welcome to Cincinnati. At your age, you obviously know that Paul McCartney was in a band before Wings. So I have to ask you, at 58, do you look at this, certainly not as a stepping stone, but as your last best stand as a head coach? And also, a second part of that question, have you gotten the assurances that you need that this university and this program can compete when it comes to resources, when it comes to scouting, when it comes to recruiting, when it comes to the stadium? Are you confident and did you get those assurances?
Yeah, I've got a lot more years. The thing about coaching is it's the players that make you feel young. Somebody asked me a long time ago, why did you want to coach? Because I was an athlete, and I wanted to stay around sports. And so I've done that all my life. That's pretty much all I've done. And because of that, it keeps you young. It keeps you feeling every day that you're the same age as these guys are. You're not. But to keep up with them, you've got to feel like you are. And so I hope I can coach a long time. I hope I can go many, many more years. I would have not decided to take this job, and I would not be here today if these two guys right here hadn't said, Coach, we want to give you every possible avenue to have the most success that you possibly can have. Now, we want our athletes, basketball, football, baseball, track, we want them to have the best that they possibly can have. A lot of it is a little overboard, but we want them to be able to compete and have the things that can make them the best possible student athletes they possibly can be. And these two guys promised that we would do that, and we're going to do it, and we're going to do it the right way, and we're going to recruit hard, and we're going to put this team together, and we're going to fight every day to win every possible game that we play. Sometimes that's not possible, but you can surely try, and we're going to give it a heck of a shot.
Hey, Coach, did the uncertainty over the Big East's future give you pause at all?
Well, you know, that's something we can't control. Again, I've been in college football a long time, and I've seen a lot of things change. You know, I was in the Big East when it first opened up. I was defensive coordinator at the University of Miami, and we joined the Big East, and it's kind of changed over the years. When I went to the Big 12 3 years ago, we had, 14 teams? I think we had 14 teams. We lose two the first year, and then we lose two the next year. You know, we had guys going in and out. The uncertainty was unbearable on fans and administrators, but you know what? It doesn't really bother coaches and players. We can't control that. The only thing we can control is if there's going to be movement and if there's going to be people that's going to take people in other conferences. We want to put our best foot forward every day where people recognize that we can be part of that. And so that's what we're going to do. We're going to make sure that everybody understands when they see us on television that we play with class, we play hard, and we're going to have a lot of success, and that anybody would be proud to have University of Cincinnati in whatever conference is out there. But we're excited about where we're at right now, but things will change. It's going to change every day for the next few years, and everybody kind of knows where it's headed. You've kind of seen it, you know, start materialize over the last few years, but we have no control. So what we want to do as a football team is we want to take advantage of every opportunity to put our best foot forward, and every time that people see us, whether it's live, in person, or on television.